hear me on the radio. True. It's your girl, Miss Listen No. Shout out to my DJ, Al.
DJ Sugar Ray in the building.
Sugar.
That is.
But before we went to break, we were just talking to our guest. His name is Malik. He's from the Bronx.
Yeah.
And we also here have Myla here from ATL,
Atlanta,
New York,
Miami,
Indiana grown.
Everywhere.
I feel like a peach now, so. You're a peach, huh?
You
trying to give
me
a peach?
Yeah, so you're
gonna
give me a peach.
I'm
just gonna say
you're
from that.
Yeah, I just want to get more into a little bit more into your business, because we actually have some incredible people up here today. Guys, make sure you check out these interviews on streetleafmovement.com, because Myla's actually Brian Michael Cox, an artist.
Nice.
And you've done a lot of great things too. You were signed with Y Club, right?
Yeah, I was signed with Y Club.
Are you Haitian?
No, I'm not. I'm African.
Is that why you? Okay. No black rights for you.
It was good though.
I love you though. Give me that grill.
But yeah, he mentored me when I was, when I was 13 until I was, 18.
Okay.
It was a really good experience. You know, he taught me the ins and outs of the industry, how to write music, how to defer a, what's a hit, what's not a hit. You know, playing live instruments, play the drums.
You play drums?
We play everything. I play everything.
Okay, that's really good. So are you guys still cool?
Yeah, that's my big brother. That's never gonna change.
So what was the separation? Why?
It was just, you know how things just, you know, it's just timing, basically. Yeah. It, you know, he was into really, you know, going. He was going for president. For
okay.
Everything happened. So, you know, it was just like still love, but he was like, yo, listen. I'm here for you if you need me.
But I mean, you're definitely still doing well.
Yeah, but that's really what like the best mentors do. Like they mentor you, they let you know what's good and what's bad, and then they know I'm gonna carry you. They be like, yo, listen.
Right.
I crafted this lane for you. Mm-hmm. You gotta go be you now. Like, they can't coddle you. You know what I mean? How else can you grow?
Right.
So, just having that in your corner, like Wyclef, you having Brian Michael Cox is just like a great thing for both of y'all careers.
And me having Beyonce, I mean.
That's a good one.
Oh, man.
Amazing what these people do for us.
Right.
But, are you also an actor?
Yes, I am. I did a couple of acting.
I know, what is it?
I played Young Simba in Lion King on Broadway.
How old were you?
I was actually, I forget how old I was, but it was like 2002. I was probably about like.
No, you see how you need publicists. You guys need a publicist. Exactly. You just gave me too much. All you had to do is throw out an age. You didn't have to give me the year happened.
Listen.
Because that show still looked like you was a cat.
2002. You gotta be young to play Young Simba, so I ain't ashamed.
Okay.
You gotta be really young.
Because I was playing Young Simba too. Mm-hmm. Very young. Don't worry. You got the young cat. Don't. Worries.
Then I'm actually in a movie called Preaching to the Choir. You can see it on BET.
Okay.
With Patti LaBelle and Eartha Kitt.
That's dope.
That's fire.
Eartha Kitt.
Yeah, the first movie I did was Me, Myself, and Irene with Jim Carrey.
Oh, that's fire.
Wait, what did they have you doing?
I actually played a stepson. I grew up to be the fat one. If you ever seen
him. Oh, you grew up to be the fat one.
Yeah. So I played the fat one when he was younger.
How was it working with him?
It was crazy. He's a funny.
Just as funny as
he's
he is.
Funny, yeah. He's
one guy. Thing I do know about him, and I respect that, is like when he's in character, he's in character.
Yeah. He is. But even when it was time for us to shoot, he would just like cut jokes on the side, make faces.
Yeah.
Like, he's just that cool.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
That's dope. Let's call him. No?
I don't have the number. Let's call him.
I'm gonna Google it.
Miss Lissa knows though. I mean, she knows.
I might know Jim.
He got caught up. not Lissa, oh wait.
Yeah, you gotta call me Jim.
Exactly.
I'm just saying. But what is your end all be all goal? Like, what would you like to come up all of this grinding?
Really just being successful. I think in the industry it's all about being long term, having a long term career in the industry, but what I really,
what are you gonna do to like maintain, like how are you gonna be the Jay-Z of R&B? Like, what are you gonna do?
Are you gonna keep reinventing yourself?
Are you gonna join Illuminati? What are you gonna do?
I'm gonna keep doing Malik. Malik is gonna keep doing me. I'm gonna keep doing me. I think that's the best way to do it. Just do you, and if people feeling it, people gonna
that's
feel
how
it.
I'm feeling it. The weekend is called Weekend or The Weekend.
Make sure you play it though.
No, we just played it. No.
But I'm making. Make sure you play it.
Don't worry. So no, I like that song.
Girls in the car.
I like that song.
It's on rotation. It's on rotation. My
and
buddy.
Milo, you have a really good song too. Like, these are some really good songs. Honesty.
Thank you.
I'm loving tonight. So before y'all go,
we gotta ask. Where do you see yourself in 5 years? Like, what do you see yourself doing?
to be honest, I come from a really, really small town. So my biggest thing is to inspire people from my city and like small cities like that to actually get up and get out and chase your dreams. Because where I'm from, they really don't think that you can get to any type of success. It's just like, yeah, you know, the homies on the corner.
Yeah.
So that's the biggest thing. I want to be like a Debbie Allen of singing. Like,
can you dance? A little bit?
I can, but no, I mean Debbie Allen of singing.
Okay.
Like, the young kids in the shape to go out into this.
Okay.
I feel like I've been through a lot, so I think I can.
What you been through? Industry relationships?
Relationships may be a strong word, but just seeing foolery, you know.
Okay.
Navigating. I don't have a lot of problems out of people.
Have you ever, you dated some, who you dated? No?
No one notable. No, actually, you know, I don't.
You
really
sure?
I don't really do the industry dating thing because it's like really small, and then you don't want to be that chick.
So you never dated any? You moving around?
I mean, I've gone out to eat.
Look at us.
We
just like,
oh,
son.
You can't get no head. Does he play basketball? He's one of our favorite rappers. Like, can we get something like that? Something fun like that?
Back up from the mic.
I won't say anyone I dated, but I will say someone that is actually a friend of mine that is a character that I know everybody knows, and that's Stevie J.
So you,
he's a character. So that's
y'all went on dates.
We hung. He gave me lots of.
I heard he's hung. Did you see that?
You know what? I will only tell this because I'm not the only person that will tell this type of story.
Okay.
Stevie will whip it out in front of anyone.
He whooped it out?
He does not care.
It's like that little baby on?
Yeah, I was like, dude,
put that away.
He was like, okay.
That's
like,
funny.
He was trying to get you on the bus, and you was like, I don't want to go on the bus.
I'm like, I don't know about these tracks, dude.
Do you do that to girls too? Just whip it out in the studio?
No. You can't. No.
Y'all can't. Is your girlfriend in the industry?
I don't have a girlfriend.
You say you did.
He's building. No, he didn't. He said.
Something like
he's mingling. He said.
No,
he's
mingling.
He's mingling.
Okay. You want
to see? You trying to trick me right now?
She's trying to catch me.
I
can help the ones that catch it right from jump. But if you was like, nah, my girlfriend, I would have just backed up on the mic. I can't help you, bro.
No, you gotta let them rock sometimes, like Larry.
I know, but
we gotta get the information to our fans. They wanna know what's happening with Brian Michael Cox artists. What's happening with Malik? That, you know what I mean?
I know. Just me being in situations and like realizing the industry, I be just realizing, like, yo, one word, one word to have you on like TMZ and hip hop gossip site.
And no, and have you a Sheely moment.
So that's why, like, you know what I mean? Sometimes I just be like if I like y'all, like,
He saving people. I just wanted to know. But let's get into, so, a little duet. How you guys want to do? A little 8 and 8? Or you want to just, like, you start singing and when you feel it, you might just have a little church moment? How should we do it?
I say she could do the chorus.
He do the 16, and then she do the chorus.
Why can't he do the chorus and she do? That's not fair.
Are we going to have an instrumental?
Yeah. No, we're going to have that.
We're
gonna
hold
that. I'm joking. Of course, our DJ Stevie Ray gonna hook y'all up. Something R&B.
Stevie Ray.
Sugar Ray.
Don't worry. I'm sorry. You can call me Miss Lisa. Everyone else messes up my name.
Lisa.
I'm a Miss Lisa Knows Show.
Well, DJ, what instrumental you got for us, man?
You want me to throw an instrumental?
Yeah, for the kids. They want to sing.
You just surprise them. Surprise anything?
Yeah, they ready.
Let's go. No, too crazy. Remember, it's an R&B interrupt.
You don't play like it. Are you comfortable with his format, or you want to go 8-8 and then hook?
Oh, we could just go in and
out.
But you know that wasn't no thought.
It be those records though.
Yeah.
It be those records where you don't really think about it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, all my best songs, I didn't think about them.
Oh, man.
It wasn't Beyonce. You did for Beyonce, right?
I wrote all her hits. She ain't give me no money. She trying to Neo with me. She trying to carry hills in my career. No, but I actually don't write for her. I'm just the Beyonce of radio, you know?
Gotcha.
Oh, I kill it for karaoke, though. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Ow.
What you got?
I
always
don't have a subject.
Oh, the subject is, ow, do you. Acid, whatever do you mean to you?
Oh,
that's what
God.
The top of it.
I'ma do me, you do you. I'ma do me, you do you. Oh, since you told me to do me, I'ma do me, you do you. I'ma do me, you do you. Girl, girl.
So, how would it feel if I go out and do the things you do? Would it feel to you if I go?
Is featuring Rashida and Kurt.
No, that was really dope. See, make sure y'all check this out on streetleaguemovement.com.
Uh-huh, for sure.
The podcast will be on pncradio.fm.
Uh-huh.
I had a blast.
Yeah.
Let us know again where we can find you guys and the music. Like, I'm ready. I want to do me.
You can find me at mylamusic.com. All of my social media is basically Myla Music. But if you want to purchase, or even how I have my album set up or my EP set up is name your price. So you can go on myla.bandcamp.com. You can pay $1, you could pay $100. You know.
Okay.
Plus your boat.
Oh,
and
if you
got an EBT card, then go ahead and hit the free download.
I'm giving you $71.
Oh, man.
And what about you?
Once again, iTunes. iTunes, The Weeknd is out 99 cents.
And we're gonna definitely put both of your songs in rotation.
Sweet.
Shout out to my DJ Sugar Ray. He's on. He had your music. Everything.
Shout out.
You're really good.
You,
good.
You got played in the clubs though too.
He won't. No, forget the club. Don't come to my DJ head. He's got exclusive events.
He got to play them.
He's gonna.
You gotta play them then.
He's gonna play them at like Diddy's house, and I don't mean Daddy's house. I mean.